Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you the difference between column filters and table filters. Let's start from green sales. Green sales is a measure that computes sales amount where color equals green. And the result of this measure is that it always shows the value of green sales even when the current selection is a different one. So the value of green is replicated in all the rows. Now, if you want to obtain a different effect, so you want green to be seen only when green is already selected, a common mistake that many people do is replacing this with a table filter. So they write filter product, where product color equals green. The net effect of this measure is exactly what it is expected. You only see green when green is already selected. The reason is important to understand. You see green because the filter context on green is the original filter context under which the measure is evaluated, and that original filter context is used during the evaluation of filter product. So this is filtering the green product where color equal green here, and it is filtering the brown product where the product is equal green here, so the result is blank. Nevertheless, using this syntax or without knowing what it does is a great mistake because you are filtering a table. Filtering a table means filtering all the columns of the table. The filter is much heavier to use and it slows down all the calculation. If you want to keep existing filters, we have already seen in a different video how to use keep filters. Filtering a table replaces the filters on the entire table. So it not only slows down the engine, but it also makes it more difficult to change parts of the filter. Indeed, if I use a filter like this and I use filter product, I might get used to this syntax and always use it. So if I want to replace, for example, the filter on color, I might use filter all product to obtain the effect of showing green everywhere. But this expression is very different than filter all product color, because by using all product, I'm replacing any filter in the table. Look what happens if I replace the color with a brand. Focus on the number. Now I'm seeing 1403, which is the sales of all the product color. And if I remove the color and I replace it with the brand, what I see is still the value of all the green product, regardless of the brand. My measure is not only ignoring any filter on the color, it's also ignoring and replacing any filter on any other column of the table. As a best practice, you should always try to use column filters instead of table filters. And if you need to filter multiple columns, then you build a table which has the minimum number of columns which are needed to obtain your goal, that is, filtering some columns. Try to avoid as much as possible the usage of table filters. Enjoy DAX!